Hi, I'm Susan Duffy-Smith, and I am a troop leader for Troop 229, and we have been working on this little production for you to share a little bit about our area where we live and go to school and work, and where we've been Girl Scouts since some of the kids in the troop were in kindergarten. That's 10 years as of the spring. It's been a really active troop. There have been a lot of fun activities. The girls enjoy the outdoors very much. We've been canoeing, we've been hiking, we've been backpacking, we like to go camping. We like to do just about anything. We're going shopping this afternoon. But pretty much anything together as a group and that's fun or that you can make fun, we do it. And that's what Girl Scouting has been all about to us. And so we'd like to share a little bit about our life here in Truckee with you and get to know you better.
Hey, I'm Rachel and I'm here to talk to you about downtown Truckee and Truckee history. Truckee is a small town located in the Sierra Nevada mountains and near Lake Tahoe. Truckee begins its boom when farmers started going west from the Midwest because of Sacramento's rich soil. Truckee is named after Chief Troquet, who served as a guide to other immigrants, including the Aaron Party. We have some really old buildings in Truckee, including the train depot, the Capitol, the Truckee Hotel, Truckee's old jail, and the Rocking Stone. The Truckee Hotel began as the American House in 1868 and burned for the first time in 1878, then again in 1881. Renamed as the Whitney House just prior to 1990, it again burned to the ground in 1909 and was rebuilt to today's structure. Truckee's old jail was built in 1875 out of native stone. The brick was added about the turn of the century. This is now one of the West's oldest jails in continuous use until 1964. The Rocking Stone is one of the 25 known rocking stones in the world. The 17-ton stone has been stabilized with cement now. So as you can see, Truckee has been around a while and is a great place to live.
Hi, I'm Katie. I'm going to tell you about the Donner Party. The Donner Party is mostly known, unfortunately, for its tragic outcome being trapped in the horrible winter of 1846, in which over half of the folks perished and some of the remaining members resorted to cannibalism in order to survive. The party was made up of two family groups, the Reeds and the Donners. They were wealthy Illinois farmers lured west by the pioneer spirit and the promise of rich lands in California. They were delayed in their journey before reaching the Sierra Nevada mountain range, since they followed the less documented Hastings cutoff. Arriving to the mountains late in the season, coupled with early October snowstorms, stranded them with dwindling provisions and no idea of what lay in store for them. The first two escape efforts failed. Eventually, James Reed managed, with a small group of men, to cross the summit and raise a rescue team. When the rescue party arrived in March, they found over half the party dead and some of the remaining cannibalized victims.
My name is Lindsay, and I'm here to talk to you about
Donner Lake is a beautiful attraction that brings many tourists each year to its beautiful shores. It is located 1 mile west of Truckee and is 8 miles around. Many people love to come up in the summer to swim in its magnificent depths. The water is cold, however, in the summer, heat is very refreshing. The lake itself has 63 inlets and one outlet. In the summer, there's lots of things to do. You can rent a Sea-Doo, a sailboat, a rowboat, a paddle boat, and just about any other boat you can think of. There is so many fun things to do around the lake. You can ride your bike or go on the exciting hiking trails or go to the China Wall. There is also a museum that is very close to the lake that talks about the Donner Party and how they lived. Donner Lake is one of the many things our little town Truckee has to offer.
I'm JJ and I'm here to tell you about Lake Tahoe.
Lake Tahoe is one of Truckee's biggest tourist attractions, the deepest lake in North America, and is located 1.5 hours east of Sacramento. It straddles the border of California and Nevada, with 1/3 of the lake in Nevada and 2/3 in California. It has 72 miles of shoreline and contains 39 trillion gallons of water. Tahoe is not only large, but is beautiful. Surrounded by mountains on all sides, it is one of the most photographed lakes in all the world. Lake Tahoe is so clear that you can see objects up to 120 feet below the surface. An average of 125 inches of snow falls on the lake every year.
This is Kim, and I'm here to tell you about the Truckee River. It runs from Lake Tahoe to Pyramid Lake. It is 140 miles long. It is home to many fish, including the Lahontan cutthroat trout. Many people use the river for fly fishing, kayaking, and whitewater rafting. Truckee River was first mentioned in the journals of John C. Fremont. Fremont gave it the name of the Salmon Troop River.
Hi, I'm Kenna. In our town, we have one high school, Truckee High, which Lindsay, Rachel, soon-to-be JJ, and I attend. We have awesome teachers. Our football team won state last year, and our academic team did too. There are 650-ish students in our high school, 56 of which are in the band. Our band director, Mr. Green, is the awesomest man alive and runs the auditorium too. We have very talented students at our school.
Hi, I'm Susan, and I chose to tell you about the Olympics in Squaw Valley because they were held in 1960. Squaw Valley is about 15 minutes down the road from Truckee on the way to Lake Tahoe. It's just one of the many large ski resorts that are surrounding the Lake Tahoe Basin, which bring thousands of skiers and snowboarders to our area each winter. Some of the other names of the big resorts you might recognize are Heavenly Valley, Alpine Meadows, and Sugar Bowl. Squaw Valley is located in the Sierra Nevada mountain range. Sierra Nevada means snowy range in Spanish, and our average snowfall ranges between 300 and 500 inches each year. We get a lot of snow. The elevation at the bottom of Squaw Valley is 6,200 feet. The elevation at the top of the tram is 8,200 feet. The highest peak, Granite Chief, is almost 10,000 feet tall. Famous names you might recognize from the 60s Olympics include Jean-Claude Killy in skiing, Dick Button and Sonia Henie on ice skates, and in 1960, the U.S. hockey team beat Russia for the first time to win the gold medal in hockey. The Squaw Valley Olympics put our area on the world map as a winter sports destination and started a lot of the boom that we've experienced in the area over the last 20 years.
Hi, I'm Debbie. I'm going to give you a little bit of history about Reno, which is near Lake Tahoe, and Truckee, where we live. Reno, Nevada has been called the biggest little city in the world, and I suppose it is because there are so many things to do and see in Reno. Reno is about 45 minutes from Lake Tahoe and the ski resorts on the eastern slope of the Sierra Nevadas. Reno's economy is fueled by tourism. Gambling is a very popular form of recreation, and Reno has many fine casinos that offer slot machines, blackjack, roulette, craps, poker, baccarat, pie-gal poker, and many other novelty games. Hot August Nights is a large event that draws thousands of tourists to the area every August. The 50s and 60s come alive again as thousands of vintage cars cruise the streets of Reno. There are sock hops, concerts, parades, and contests that keeps everyone entertained. The women all dress up in poodle skirts, and the men all look like James Dean or Fonzie in Happy Days. Every year, Reno hosts the State Fair and Rodeo at the Livestock Center. Reno has truly grown from a very small town to the biggest little city in the world.
Hi, my name is Carol, and I'm here to tell you about Verde, Nevada, which is my hometown. Verde was founded in 1867 by the Central Pacific Railroad. Another thing that's gone through Verde is the first transcontinental road, the Lincoln Highway, which eventually was turned into highway, mostly Highway 80, that continues to this day. We have a major resort called Boomtown. Been there since the early 70s and started out as a truck stop along Interstate 80, but has grown to a $50 million
resort.
Hi, I'm Mary, and I'm going to talk to you a little bit about sports in Truckee, California. I love sports. Local winter sports in our area include downhill and cross-country skiing, ice skating, ice fishing, snowshoeing, winter camping. All of these sports can be enjoyed right out our back doors or within a half an hour driving distance. Summer sports include mountain and road biking, hiking, backpacking, swimming, sailing on the lakes, fishing, many more. In our family, this also includes unicycling and cheerleading. The Truckee area provides a beautiful backdrop for us to enjoy our physical fitness and experience sports at a great outdoor level.
To finish our Girl Scout Troop 229 video from Truckee, California, we will leave you with a collection of Girl Scout pictures.